Greetings from Antwerp, Belgium. This is Melan Hsiao from Belgian Chinese Tea Association. My journey started when I was about 8-9 years old. As the eldest daughter in the family, it was my duty to prepare tea during the weekend when I'm home for my parents. My mom has very difficult, troublesome physical conditions. She could have a different chronic problems in different seasons. And also, since I was young, along the way, I noticed that she need different kinds of attentions from time to time. That is the reason why when I choose tea and make tea for her, I have to pay extra attention to what kind of tea she can drink and how to brew that tea to make sure the tea does not upset her stomach or sleeping quality. So you can say my mom was my first inspirator to learn about tea. But my learning point is not about tea itself. As a matter of fact, I start to learn the tea with health according to Chinese traditional yin and yang wisdom. Then in 1985, I was nearly burned out. I stood on the crossroad in life. I start to question myself, who am I? What am I doing? What is the future to be? At that moment, I have no answer. All I know is I like to drink tea. I want to go to the nature to enjoy a cup of tea. That was the voice to me. So I started to learn tea with a tea farmer in Mao Kong tea region in Taipei region. With this tea farmer family, now I enjoyed very good quality tea. With them, I have the pleasure to see how they take care of tea farm, how did they pick tea, how did they make tea. And all of a sudden, I realized what attracted me to tea is not just about the fine flavor and the good taste. Actually, I was inspired, moved, and touched by those people who, I don't know their name, who work very hard in their life to show respect to the nature and also traditional wisdom. Hand-picked quality tea, manually processed. I was moved and touched by the human value behind tea leaves. I start to fall in love with tea even more without knowing. In 1991, because I'm married to a Belgian, so I moved to Belgium. Left Taiwan was a difficult decision, but I was very, very happy because it gave me a chance to stand out of my comfort zone. And I have a chance to see tea and engage tea and to learn tea, appreciate tea from all over the world, certainly from mainland China. So I could learn tea by drinking tea. Often people ask me, who was my teacher? Who I learned tea from? I always said, well, the first person is my mom, and the second is tea. Tea provides us a lot of freedom to choose. And tea provides us comfort to the heart. Living in Belgium, from time to time, I'm homesick. So what I do is I start to invite friends for Chinese food and, of course, share tea with them. Then it was my Belgian friend encouraged me, asked me to start to teach tea. With the group, the first group of Belgian ladies, I realized that they did not know about tea. They did not know what tea and how to choose tea, how to brew tea, how to appreciate tea. So when I started the journey, I said to myself, it is not about business. It is about helping people to appreciate tea because there are so many good people in the world are looking for good tea. And vice versa, there are so many good teas are looking for good people to appreciate them. That's what I'm doing. That's what my vow to tea. Tea could not speak. Tea simply provide. As long as you have open-minded, as long as you are willing, when you have a cup of tea, tea start to talk with you. When you fall in love with tea, what you fall in love with is not tea itself. As a matter of fact, it is you in the reflection of tea. I do hope one day I can welcome you to visit Belgian Chinese Tea Center in Antwerp so we could have a cup of tea.